So today I am looking at this scenario and I'm pretty familiar with it. I mean, I don't have my team members aren't chronically late, but we do have some team members that at times don't perform at the level that we need them to, and it affects the other team members. So with this, I've learned what not to do when I first started. You don't want to just go in and say, "Hey, you're currently here and I need you here. What happened? Why are you not there?" Whenever I did that when I first started, I'm just not afraid of confrontation, so I didn't mind just asking the question. But I realized the team members never really took accountability when you approached them that way. They would often make excuses and get very defensive. And when they're backed into a corner and they're defensive, they're not looking for a way to improve and grow. They're just trying to make sure they don't get in trouble for what they've done. And a lot of times when you first have this conversation, they're so worried about being in trouble. So this is where I'm curious if you think this approach is correct. But first time, I always say, this one's on me. This is our first time talking about this. You're not at the level that you need to be at right now. So I've either not gave you the clear vision, I've not set the expectations, I haven't provided the tools, or maybe you just don't have the training you need to be there right now, but I need you to get there. So please let me know, what can I do to help? Do you need training? Do you need more tools? Do you need more time? We can walk through some processes. And then once you show that you're there to help them and you're gonna provide whatever it takes to get them there, they're gonna be more bought into to getting to the level where you need them. Now, the tricky part on this is the part in 100x Leader where it says, people change when they see what it's like to be on the other side of themselves. This is so difficult because once you try to tell the team member how their performance, their low performance is affecting the team, they automatically feel guilty and want to go back into that defensive mode. So you have to be very careful how you craft this conversation. And it's more of like, what I do is I say what I see. I notice that Patty is doing a little more to help you out, but I don't think she's able to 100% focus on her job task because she's helping you with yours. So I really need you to be able to fully take on your job. That way Patty can focus on hers, and giving them ownership and then kind of letting them see how they're affecting other people. That's kind of what it's like to get them to see what it's like on the other side of them, but it is still a very, very difficult conversation to have. So that is what I do. I always say, first time's on me, try to provide the tools to help them through it. And so far, it's working out, but I am grateful I have a really good team, but I'm still trying to learn all I can because I know I'm not going to be the supervisor over inventory forever. I'm going to eventually move on to higher roles where I will have more challenging conversations with team members who may not be as bought in. So I'm curious for any feedback you may have about the way I currently do things. Thanks.